The following program was produced or sponsored by a community member. The content, views, and opinions expressed are the sole responsibility of the producer and do not reflect those of Malden Access Television, the City of Malden, or your cable provider. MATV welcomes your comments. Please call us at 781-321-6400 or email us at access@matv.org.
Welcome to the MNBL's Week 3. Speaking of Week 3, 3-0 versus 3-0 in Week 3. Pistons versus Hawks, Brad with Benton, Nesta Dudley, Storm and Norman on camera. Welcome to the action.
Brad, these are the last two champions, the defending Neighborhood League champs, the Hawks, on a 19-game win streak, if you include the Madness and the Big Dance.
That's true.
The Pistons, the 20-09 champions. And, Brad, the last time in 20-09 when the Pistons when the Pistons won the title, it was Paul Conrad was the head coach, and Anthony Guerrero was the assistant coach, and Kyle White was on the Hawks.
Yeah. Twist. What is Twist? Give it to him and shoot a three. He's got 7 threes on the year, Jonah Saint.
Kyle White playing the cleanup man, the garbage man, and the Hawks come out pressing, Brad.
They always do. What a bad pass.
He didn't even look.
Nope, not at all. He saw a white jersey and hoped it was there. The Pistons have to play a slow-paced offense and let Raymond Yang do his thing with the point.
After today's contest, we will see exactly where the Pistons stand.
Right now, they're tied for the top of the league. Totally different team than the 20-09 team, but, wow, he got picked. And we got a little foul.
Raymond Yang blew an opportunity. He should have had his head up and just given the outlet. The guy was there, Brad.
He had him. At half court, you got to look up.
Jumping Jehoshaphat.
The clock's working.
Well, wiggle my webs and call me Shaky.
Okay, Shaky.
By the way, I've been killing you on the combo tens this season. Just killing you.
Yeah, you have?
Yes.
Have I been there?
I've been killing you. Doesn't matter.
Oh, that's true.
You and Go Ref Go has been...
Oh, that's just wonderful. Glad to hear that. Your year's going out well. Kyle White trying to get his shot attempts started early. He's averaging 38 a game.
Oh, that's a travel, Brad.
A
there
big
you
travel.
Go.
Dave got a call right. Amazing. And it's that early in the game. Good for Dave. That was a good call, Ref Dave, and it's only in the first quarter. I'm very shocked you got one right. We love Dave here in the cable cast.
He took a shower. He was squeaky clean. I think he was Irish Spring clean, Brad.
Was he tipping? Was he tasting it?
No, he wasn't tasting it.
Okay,
no,
then he's wide awake and ready to go. Nice play by Yang. Throws it off Joey Pepe.
That's a certain sports figure from Stone Mountain, Georgia that tastes.
Oh, yes, that is true. Stone Mountain, Georgia. That's where Beauty Benton's is staying right now.
Beauty Benton.
Hanging out with tasting it. That's a nice pass. That's a beautiful pass.
That was nice, Brad.
Good work. See, you don't have to dribble through a press. If you pass through a press, you will break it that much easier.
As I mentioned at the tap, Brad, the Hawks are on a 19-game win streak. There's only one player on this team that knows what defeat tastes like. And Brad, chances that this team's gonna go undefeated is very slim.
Yeah, very
but
slim.
But what do you think would happen if they ever have that first loss? I'm not saying they're gonna lose today, but the odds are against them retaining perfection.
That is true. It's a nice move by Jose who missed it. But yeah, it's gonna be tough for them to repeat this year. Nice pass. Beautiful. He almost blew it.
Is that Jonah Saint?
Jonah Saint hit his first basket of the day. They're still doing the 21. Now they, oh, what a bad pass, Jose. Fake a pass. He was already off his feet before he even lifted his arm.
Jose's close to an early entry.
Another bad pass.
He's just throwing it up. They just get somebody else to inbound.
Kyle White, you know he's not passing. Yeah, Josh Jose should not be throwing the ball in.
I think Lang Tang wants to call a timeout. He said they don't know what they're doing.
That's true.
And you know what? No two words were ever spoken. They had no idea what they were doing. Brad, he just threw up the ball that last. Just warm it up. He's like, I don't want potato. I don't want it.
Well, he thought Carmelo was. Now, everyone knows John Carmelo is a great three-point shooter. But John Comello is very flat-footed, and he's not fast. He tried to throw it over Comello to get, you know, him to lead into the pass, but he was already facing him, so it takes him too much to turn around. He's not quick enough, hence Jonah Saint comes over, beautiful play, taps it backwards towards the other end, and his own teammate picks it up. They go in front of the layup. Good play, Jonah Saint stepping up for the Hawks today so far. Ali Joseph got a basket, he's got one. Kyle White's got one, 6-2.
Brad, do you have the official stats?
After this weekend, we will have the stats. Always after week three, because work commitments, people still not paying up, people still not making games. Everyone's guaranteed at least to play four games by the end of this weekend, then we do the stats.
Speaking about people not playing games, on my rosters, I have a couple of folks that haven't played yet. Maybe at some point we can take a look and I can ask you if you know if these folks are still in the league.
Yeah, I was actually contacting the Celtics coach because he had two players on his roster because I was doing the stats, and I see two or three names with zero games played.
I think that's the team that I'm thinking of too.
Okay, I know that the Pistons, Lichtenberg, played his first game last Sunday.
Yes.
So he was the only zero I had on their squad, so now he's all set, and he's here today.
Are there any zeros on the Hawks squad?
I'll tell you right now.
I thought there was two. Or maybe I'm thinking of a different team. Or maybe I'm thinking of the Celtics.
Yusef Muhammad and Jordan James are not played yet.
They have not played, correct?
Correct.
Those are the two.
Yep. Yang with a three. A pure three, they'd call it in Malden. Once he starts getting warmed up, I think Yang's going to be here. You know, that player that we're all waiting to see. Everyone says he's the best shooter in Malden. Once he starts getting warmed up, it's going to help the Pistons even more. They're already 3-0, and he's still not hitting. Jose, who's got a few threes on him this year. Josh Jose, I believe he's got three or four threes on him.
Ali Joseph, quicker than a hiccup.
Over to Jonah Saint, back to Ali for three. He gets his first. His second attempt, he hits the second one, he's 50%. There's Comello where he always is, and he's not paying attention. Nice play by Comello.
They call a timeout. Comello's looking for a foul and stop playing. Brad, they've used two timeouts and we haven't even played half of
Not even 5 minutes gone. Milton Osborne is on his feet.
Listen to Coach Milt Osborne.
Get that on camera. Milton Osborne is screaming. Every single time. We need the wireless. Or a boom mic.
How many years he's been coaching here, Brad? That's the loudest I've ever heard him.
Yeah. He's been here, I think it's his 5 years now. This year.
This is the loudest I've ever heard him.
Well, I heard him before the timeout. He was going off down there for some reason. He did not look happy. We have a Piston alum showing up into the game. Part of that 09 roster. Former Celtic, now turned Piston, turned graduate.
And sitting on the Hawks side. He showed no MNBL team loyalty.
Danny Batu is done. Well, it's a totally different Piston team.
Anthony Guerrero's still here.
Yeah. But he's only one of 13. Comello misses his first three attempt. Nice rebound, bad shot attempt. There's nothing there. Good, kick it out. That was smart.
Takes 3 seconds. There you go.
Bonaco gave the fist pump right there. Thought he was going Jersey Shore, but he only did it once. He's too hip-hop to go Jersey. Hans Marcelin coming into the game.
I don't know who he was passing that to, Brad.
He was passing it to the wall, but the wall was fired from WCW back in 2001. What a bad pass. Josh Jose should not be passing the ball in. That's his third mistake.
Well, I don't know who should be passing the ball in. And they're just panicking under the pressure.
Yeah, they're not getting open. They're not fighting, setting picks. There's a good steal. And a foul by Jonah Saint. It's a good foul for the Pistons. I see the two coaches got clipboards and Tui Nguyen's coming over and telling them what to do. I like it. That's communication.
The Pistons are staying on the perimeter.
Yeah, that's
not going to get it done.
Yeah, you're passing within 3 feet of each other. 0 for 2? No, he got that one.
Comello dropped like six of them last game, Brad.
Yeah. He's got 10 on the year. in three games, but then Rayshon Hopkins has 14 in three games. He had 7 last Sunday. '98 Pistons came right back.
Rayshon Hopkins had 21 points. They were all threes.
Yeah. 7 threes last Sunday. Raymond Yang by himself. Nice play. And they have their first lead with a 20-point combo. Oh, sorry, I'm wrong. And minus one.
Damn it! Oh, I'm smoking you a go, ref go.
Oh, in and out. Gotta get that finger roll, baby. He ain't passing.
Brad, I'm not sure if the Hawks have been, is this the first time that the Hawks have been playing from behind this season?
I believe so, because they always jump out real early. Prince Mukala, first game today for the Pistons, just came out. Replaced by Alex Armand, who's now into the game. Camelo looks up. He's on the wrong side of the hoop, but he made it. Did he make it right? Yes.
That was a shooter's roll. And the Hawks call the timeout. And you know
that. The Pistons, they're pumped.
And you, oh. Milt Osborne might explode.
Storm and Norman on the Hawks right now.
I don't
now.
Think Milt Osborne wants to talk to him. He's like back off. He's like, all right, go on your bad self. You don't want to listen.
Yeah. Well, this is going to happen when you have a team that can keep up with you down coast to coast. Marco Jean-Baptiste showing up with the wrong side shirt.
And walking in like he's 15 minutes early.
And the fans are letting him know it. Well, the Pistons all smiles right now. I wouldn't get too happy because these Hawks can turn it around real quick. But right now it's all momentum-wise as Pistons way. Hawks were up 6-2. Next thing you know, Pistons now up 12-9. What a comeback. I don't see Marco subbing in anytime soon. We're glad he's here.
And it all depends how dire the situation gets. You might see him. You might not see him in there for the first half.
That's true. Marco Baptiste, not a bad player. Good pickup for him, sophomore.
But, you know, and let... Maybe he called and said he's going to be late.
It's possible. He could have been stuck at work. Or he could have been stuck like me at Market Basket for an hour and a half waiting in line.
Maybe he was behind you.
I hope not. Because that line was long. White 7.
Alex Armand.
Who else is, I'm seeing who else on the bench. Okay.
So he's playing his first game.
A three by Kyle White, who's taken about 8 shot attempts. He's on pace for 32 shot attempts today. Oh, that was a traveling violation? It could have been, because he was tapping it to himself and moving his feet, so it could have been a good call.
That got a crowd reaction, that call.
Yep, the fans want to see the Piston win. Jimmy Keddie, a nice block by Yang. Put a little Yang on that block. Oh, bad pass, Camelo. See you later. Nice play by Joseph. Turned right into Jose.
We knew, he says, take him out. That must be at least 2 on him.
Lichtenberg coming in the game. Now, this is a strange, this is going to be a tough substitution.
That's a pair. That's a pair and a half on Jose.
He's got 3.
Pair. Ooh. We knew you said take him out.
Oh yeah.
You haven't even played a full 10, Brad.
That's right. Out of control.
How does that happen, Brad? You got 2 fouls, and the coaches should be aware of this.
Yeah, they should have got him out earlier.
You know, that third foul, I'm blaming it on the coaching staff.
Yeah, and I'm going to say this about the coaching staff right now: Lichtenberg coming into the game slows them down immensely. He's not quick. He doesn't move the ball quick, and he's bringing if he brings the ball up. But I think Yang's running the point the whole time, which won't hurt them as much.
Well, if
but
you don't bring in Lichtenberg, then who do you bring in? He's
in the game, fired up the air ball.
He didn't hit a damn thing, Brad. Not a damn thing. Went on the floor and jacked it up.
5 seconds on the court, throws an air ball.
You know what? Matter of fact, I think I just made up something new. He didn't jack it up. He jerked it up. Can you take a shot like that, your first shot?
You
jerked it up.
Kyle Lloyd coming out disgusted. And they put Marco Jean Baptiste in.
Oh, like I said, well,
maybe he did
I'm
call.
The situation get.
There goes Lichtenberg. Nice pass to Yang. Oh,
they left him all by his lonesome. They backed off him. He has the reputation of being the purest shooter in the entire city, and he backed up off him.
Yeah, that was not good. Great pickup. First pick in the draft this year, and he's living up to the hype. Nice hesitation on the pass. Beautiful job by Yang. Carmelo for three. The Pistons are trying to just bury this Hawks team right now. You gotta not rely on a three.
The Pistons need to go on the inside.
They do. The Hawks know they're going to shoot threes.
This is not the Piston team of two seasons ago that were able to live by the
three. Bad pass and perimeter. A foul. Absolutely. They got to take it in to open up the outside.
MJ Baptiste.
MJ? Have you seen the latest photos of MJ? Sitting down at the beach smoking a cigar? He looks like he's out of shape for the first time in his career. He's all got a little belly now. Puffing on a cigar. Oh, well, Danny Batou finally comes back to his team.
Well, he's earned it.
After hanging by the Hawks bench.
He's earned it. I'm talking about the real MJ.
What's happening, Daniel? Speaking of Daniel, how's Bellin?
Doing good, working.
That's good. You need to do that. Are you not working? You're just hanging out, bumming around? Nice, very nice. Going to school and working. You
what
heard that.
Going to?
Hey, school, man. I don't care where you go. Ain't no shame in admitting where you are.
As long as you're not lying around doing nothing, getting fat.
Exactly.
We don't want to hear that.
Baptiste with three. I mean, Jonas Saint. Jonas Saint's got his first three of the game. 15-13, early ending of the first quarter here. Yang to Lichtenberg, making a move. Oh, bad pass. I hate when they make that one-handed pass. It never works. Sebastian Vosey with the foul. Sorry, yeah, Sebastian Vosey going to the line. If I had the stats, I'd tell you how he was on the year, but we don't know. Doesn't look good. Misses both. MJ Baptiste. A nice block by Lichtenberg with the corner foul.
You said Lichtenberg was a fleet of feet, but he was hanging then.
He was pretty good there. He actually looked good on the last offensive transition as well. Maybe they put some Red Bull in his water today. Gives you wings.
I've heard.
The alley hits the first. Very good free throw shooter. He was in the top 10 last year. So he's probably, he's good odds he's going to hit it.
15's a wild combo 30?
Yes. I'm going to give you that, but I was going to say 30 combo anyway. Carmelo, that's a poor shot. He was hit someone in his grill. Nice save by Alley. Baptiste with the shot, no good. The buzzer never went off.
At the end of the first 10, we're all knotted up 15 apiece, Brad.
Yep, both teams knotted up at 3-0. Both teams knotted up at 15-15. The momentum went a little bit back towards the Hawks. The Pistons were on a high for the last 4 minutes of the quarter, and the Hawks turned it on with 1 minute to go.
So Nguyen is still questioning that carry call that was, three basketball minutes ago?
That's true. Chris Rogers in the house, freshly shined.
Huh? No.
A little pause here. The Hawks, like you said, defending champions the year before the Pistons. Different squad for the Pistons. Not so different squad for the Hawks. Couple new replacements. Both teams vying for that top spot. Someone will drop to second. Someone will stay in first. tomorrow's games, I got to find a schedule. I know I have one. Tomorrow. These two teams are off tomorrow, so they get to sit down for a week, whoever wins, and bask in the glory.
And the other one is wallowing in defeat.
Yeah, for a week.
Yes.
That looks like a double dribble. They're going to call a foul, but he double dribbled.
Well, you know what, Brad? It's probably actually best that I think we're all going to benefit that both teams are off tomorrow, because that means their practices Thursday night, they were solely concentrating on each other.
Yes.
They didn't have to split their attentions between another team.
Well, just to check up on that, the Hawks' next game will be against next Saturday, third game against the Sonics. And then they got third game on Sunday against the Bullets. Pistons next game. They only play Saturday at 2:30 against the Lakers. Carmelo's just launching him up. I don't even think he has direction where he is right now.
Uh-oh, he's gonna go.
Oh, he lost his own handle and Yang fell. Lucky he lost that handle, because he was gone. Nice block by Yang.
And he looked at him. He said, you had this nerve.
That's my son. MJ Batiste throwing it in, throws it away. Commissioner with those Brandeis moves. See that extension? Catching the ball like that. Now we have a new referee today. I did see Benaco Stroud hanging around him a lot before the game began. I'm not insinuating anything, I'm just saying.
And he's ready. He's taking a page from referee Mike's playbook when rocking the shorts.
Yeah, but so far he's doing a good job.
Are you saying Mike doesn't?
I'm not saying nothing.
3 seconds, they're camping.
They have, that's a second violation. Chris Rogers up here shaking hands, kissing babies. Could be going into politics next year right here. Joseph with his second three of the game. Hawks back up three.
Huh?
Just don't let Carmelo keep launching. Play a more patient game. Oh, don't, up. You got one man down, someone's open. Nice shot.
Who was that, Brad?
That, I believe, is, Manjo Chahal. Kedian throws it up and
put it on the floor, he didn't have to.
Yep.
He was right there.
Too much upper body strength, to think. He did bulk up a little over the summer.
I know he didn't have to put on the floor. He was right there. You got to know the position. And Joey Pepe checks in, the truest Hawk of them all.
Okay. Now, why is he the truest Hawk? I'm confused.
I don't know. That just rolled off my tongue.
It sounded good.
I guess the truest Hawk of all you could say is Kyle White, because he's been there the longest.
Yeah. 2.5 seasons. Well, the truest Hawk is Benaco Stroud. Forever wearing the colors. That was a travel. Got away with it.
Kyle got a one-man press on.
Yang trying to find an opening. Finds Carmelo again, same spot, same result. He's 1 for 5. Carmelo not having a good shooting day, but he'll warm up. He's got to rely on two-pointers too, they count. And Willen's yo-yo, travel. Yo-yo-yo, it was a travel.
Is it Willen's yo-yo or Edwin's?
Willen's. Oh, Edwin's.
Okay,
I think so, you're right. I'm thinking of
Willens of the another team.
Edwins.
Oh, nice block. Nice piece by Yang, causing deflection. Nice defense there by Marcelin. Kyle White ain't passing. They should have doubled on him. There you go. Carmelo, that's where he's got to get. You're not hitting threes. Go inside. Oh, they're putting Jose back in. Three fouls in the first half.
First period.
Yeah. He gets one more. He's sitting till the fourth. Sean Hickey beside himself with no camera work to do. He looks confused and lost. But Andy's here to keep him company, which doesn't help.
I was going to say, speaking about confused and lost.
Exactly. They should make the remake to Lost and Confused, starring them two. Kind of like a spin-off of a spin-off, Dumb and Dumberer. Carmelo hits the second. Subs coming in for Carmelo, who's struggling. He's just trying too hard. If he just relaxes, he'll be fine.
Is this his first time on the bench, Brad?
Yes, it is. Played the first 16, now he sits.
And we got a combo of 40.
We do. You didn't hear me say that?
No, I didn't hear you say
that. Oh, I thought you might have heard me. Inside, nice steal. Got to relax. Jose bringing the ball up. Best spot for him as long as he doesn't charge. Oh, and he went for it. The Hawks play a high 2-3, or is it a 3-2 they're playing? Because it just looks like there's three people up top. Pepe, White, and Ali are all up top.
Brad, every time I turn to my right, I'm seeing a young Andrew Robinson eating something.
Are you seeing him or his belly?
His belly first, then him.
Yeah, true.
His jaws.
His belly. His belly's leading the way. He slipped into depression after he lost that girlfriend. It's been downhill. Josh Jose not doing very well at the line this year. I know that. I was doing the stats yesterday. Stats are updated. They're just not posted. The standings and schedule are. Nice block. He's got to be careful down there. Oh, bad pass.
That was an ill-advised pass.
Nice tap by Yang. Knocks it out. Ooh, that was almost a double dribble. Looked like he batted it down with two hands. Nice rebound by Kedian. Couldn't get it to go. And Jose loses it. Still Hawk ball. Jose's got to slow down and relax. Don't try to outrun Ali Joseph. It ain't going to happen. Smart move by Pepe, calling him over for help. Kyle White, 30-year-old man. Not going to call him a virgin because we don't know him. Tell me he don't look old. He's got that old facial features. Don't look no 18 to me. Yang for three. He's got his third one. Now that was a purely beautiful shot.
Only Brad would give us commentary like that. 22-21 with 2 minutes and 35 ticks left to go in the half.
Did you see that pure shot by Raymond Yang? There he goes again. All they got to do is stand there, and it's a charge. He doesn't pass. If Kyle White passed, he'd be so dangerous. Oh, here comes my man, Jimmy Hsu, coming into the game. Who's he coming for? Oh, Pepe, who just came into the game.
No, Pepe's been in the game for a while.
Has he?
Yeah, remember?
I thought he just subbed in.
Remember I said the truest talk?
Yeah, I thought he was the last sub they made. Oh, well. Doesn't matter. Jimmy Hsu's in the game. That's all that matters. Gotta relax. Gotta relax. Whoa!
Ain't no help, man.
The Pistons are throwing the game away. They were up five, now they're down one. Literally bad passing. Hans coming out of the game, he just came in. Shooting. He's got it. Back up four. 2 minutes to go in the calf. They got to learn how to get inside. They're relying too much outside the three-point line. Now look at them. There's three of them out there. Another throwaway. I'll tell you right now, if I was drafting a football team for a quarterback, I wouldn't take any of these Pistons because no one's hitting anyone on the button. Finally got that travel call. He does it most of the time and they don't see it. Jonas Sain, who's been on the bench for a while. And Andy Perez into the game for the first time. He's ready to play. Armand back in for the Pistons. Oh, almost another bad pass. Yang stops and pops. He's got four. Back down to one. Oh, Jonas Sain for three. No good. Air ball. Yang trying to get the Pistons the lead once again. Oh, nice pass back. Beautiful finger roll.
That's the way to take advantage of being a southpaw.
Absolutely. That's how you take advantage of passing the ball correctly.
And they got the lead up by one, Brad.
Pistons came back. The Hawks had the momentum. Shoe will launch a three. He's got one this year. So don't wait on him.
It's staying here.
56.6. I still can't believe the clock's fixed. Couldn't see who shot that. Kedian with a nice play. Oh, and they're calling a foul. That was a clean block. And they're going to call it on Jose. Oh, he's got four.
Yeah. What? Yeah, I'm commenting the game.
Huh? You what?
Yeah, excuse Brad. He's taking a personal phone call right now.
Okay.
Could possibly be his bookie. I don't know.
All right. Well,
he lost his shirt last week. He had the Patriots.
All right. Right up.
Actually, I'd like to comment on that comment. I heard you. Aren't you the one that reported last week that I was taking the Jets and didn't the Jets win?
And then you corrected me and said, hell no, you were taking the Patriots.
I took the Jets.
So you lied last week or you're lying now.
I just don't want to give anyone my picks. Hey, I won $40. Nope, saw that back door. He's missing that one. Got to grab that rebound. Good job, Camelo. 25 seconds.
Plenty of time. From the Pistons, why not call a timeout? Set up something.
Might as well go for last
drop,
shot.
Drop something.
Yang didn't want the three, smart. Camelo, you know, he was trying to shoot it before he even had it.
Yes, all he saw was that net.
He's in too much of a hurry today. He's got to slow down. Four seconds. Shoot for three. Got to shoot it. Shoot, look at my man. He had a decent look. All right, the end of the first half. 26-25 in favor of the Pistons. Pistons got their momentum back, then it seemed to flatline on both teams. Hawks got it back, Pistons got it back, flatline. Where do you see the second half going?
I see this coming down to the wire. We are seeing why both teams are undefeated and on top of the MNBL right now.
Tied at 15 at the end of first, only down one. A rarity, the Hawks are down one at the first half. If they don't turn it up and start moving the ball a little better and making better shot selections, I think the Hawks are starting to rush their shots. They're not passing like they normally do. They're not getting out on the giddy-up because the Pistons are doing a good job having men coming back. So it looks good for the Pistons right now, but we'll have to wait and see. We still got a whole half a game. And there's Mary getting right involved in camera, always trying to get FaceTime.
Where
You know, Run DMC used to say, Mary, Mary, why are you bugging? With that, Brad with Benton, Nesta Dudley, Storm and Norman, see you after the half.
Why are you bugging? Back at the half, Nesta Dudley, Storm and Norman. Behind the camera, Brad with Benton smuggling Pepsis. He'll be here shortly. Twenty-sixes knotted up. Both teams, as we said in the first half, unblemished. Somebody's going home with the L. When you penetrate and Monaco Stiles looking for over the back. Referees call a jump ball. Hawks coaches are looking for the over the back. And it's going to remain jump ball. Now Brad smuggling a whole case of Diet Coke. Camelo doesn't get it to roll. Jonas ain't with the strong side rebound. Ali Joseph kicks it off cross court to Kyle White. Back to Jonas Saint. Going to take all three of these. Butter. Hawks up by four. Excuse me, three. 29-26. That did not look like a walk to me. It looked like one elongated step. They're still questioning that call. Brad, you're just smuggling soft drinks. You didn't even smuggle we would.
I'm smuggling. I'm talking about it.
I had to go get some beverages.
I'm posh too, you know.
I didn't know you didn't have anything. We gotta communicate.
Well, do I have anything? You see Lester here. He has all my money.
Oh, that's right. I forgot he was here.
Lester
still
is. Lester's a teenager, Brad.
I know, and he got taller.
No way.
I see he trimmed his hair a little bit, not as fluffy, but he's still got the puff.
Ali Joseph
gets another three for himself.
Combo is 60.
There you go. I got one again.
No, you only got one.
Now I got the third. 40, you're 10, got, you're 15.
You're up to zero now.
I am zero because that was a negative. Oh, inside from Chahal. Turnaround. I don't think you saw the rim. Not sure if I'm a fan of the Reese's Whips.
Well, it's 40% less fat. You gotta have the fat in your candies. I'm sorry, that's my opinion.
Yeah. I mean, it's okay, but eh. Wow, he just threw that up. He didn't even look. Stepped out of bounds.
You know, I don't like this low calorie. I don't like this low fats. I don't like these,
you
know.
Because you have the metabolism of a hummingbird.
I don't like these light sugars. Let me tell you. I like my fats. I like my calories. And I want all my syrups heavy.
Joey Pepe with a nice move.
Light syrup.
I'm with you on the syrup. There is a light syrup that I do enjoy, but for the most part, I want a homemade Vermont maple thick syrup. Pistons are using their timeouts today.
Down by 10, Brad.
That was quick. Hawks had a good little speech in that locker room, I bet. Pistons probably sitting there all confident and didn't realize what they were up against. Milton do a lot of talking today. I barely heard Jovan.
You missed it. Jovan and Banaco, they were looking for a travel call. I forget who took it. Someone took an elongated step. Now, to me, it was fair. It wasn't a travel to me. But Banaco and Jovan, they saw multiple steps. I saw one elongated step, and I thought it was clean. Referees thought the same thing because they did not blow the whistle. And the guy was hacking the act, taking it to the rack. He went to the line where everything is free for the and one. Not the and one that Javon Walcott always looking for, but an and one nevertheless.
True. Commissioner Mazonson going to get some light bulbs on that scoreboard. The six looks like a five. Lost it, but he kept it inside to Marcelin. Little off balance, shouldn't have went that way. Andy Perez trying to find Allie. Allie trying to cross him up. Andy Perez inside. He got a little taller over the summer. He's trying to get his. Piston ball. Pistons need to start shocking the Hawks and going down low. But they need to do it on balance. Everybody's shooting sideways. Yang wanted it. Gives it to Camelo, who goes inside. Should have kept dribbling. He would have had the rim by himself. Got nervous and pulled up.
Camelo.
He's off. He's ice cold today. He hit his peak last week with six. Tied him out. Nice pick by Pepe. Nice try. Good effort. There goes Hans. He's hitting the floor. Watch. On the floor. Well, almost. He was going.
Yeah, he just only has a pair of fouls.
He doesn't have many fouls any games. I don't see him committing many fouls. Know what I did notice? John Camelo barely fouls ever. He doesn't play much D, I see. Plays 36 out of 40 minutes and he has one foul. He's maybe either that good or he doesn't play D.
I was going to say, maybe he respects the rules of the game.
It's possible. Can't insinuate anything, but three games, he's got four fouls. Inside for Kedian. Nope, a little higher off the glass, he would have had it. Oh, they're calling a foul? Oh no. He fouled out. Oh, four. He's got four. That's all right. Oh, forced the pass, wasn't there. That's a foul on Kedian. They're boxing one on Yang. They're putting Kyle White on him. That takes away from Kyle White scoring. Oh, that was a slap. He ain't catching him.
It just ain't gonna happen.
3:20 to go. Up 11. They're making Yang work, and it's, oh, Camelo got to see that.
Amon got to make those, Brad.
He does. He got the pass a little late, but still had plenty of time to hit it. Carmelo, very good free throw shooter, was in top 10 at the end of last year. Misses the first. He's having a tough game today. The high scoring affair. Both team averaging both in the 50s. I believe the Pistons average 60 even per game. Hawks are at 56. And misses the second, that's very rare. He ain't gonna cut him off. He's gonna beat you. Allie trying to help. Good block there. Good block there by Kyle. Pretty good strategy so far, bottling up Yang. They could have someone else bring up the ball. He's getting worn out. Down 13. Putting Jose back in, that could be dangerous.
Taking out Raymond.
Yeah.
Raymond Yang.
He needs a rest, he's getting bottled up. Jose with the ball, trying to get through. Travel.
Oh, travel.
Yeah, it's a good call.
Tweet Nunez, tell them 2 steps.
I saw Tweet. A bump, then 2 steps.
He got that disgusted look on his face.
He does. He had the gas face last week.
If anything, I would have called that a charge.
Oh, that was a travel.
With the travel.
That was a travel. That was 3 steps. They didn't catch it.
Oh,
hey, there you go.
David Yang's nutting up.
He's right. He's absolutely right. That was. Shut up.
43 and 27. Oh, Dave said, You gotta be kidding me. I don't know this.
He's still complaining about that travel.
Brad, I think we might see a technical.
Fouls on Perez. 2:14 to go in the third. Pistons are at a loss. A little confused right now. There's a foul on Joseph. Allie does that. He gets away with a lot. He's very quick. Sometimes too quick for himself. Oh. MJ Baptiste with the extra large shirt on.
And he honestly didn't think he fouled him. Hawks call a timeout, 43-27, 2 minutes and 7 ticks left to go in the third. Hawks up. Pistons have lost their composure. The coaches are looking for traveling calls. They're jawjacking with referee Dave. He ain't going to reverse the call.
No. Once a call's made, that's official, that's it. They can try to make up for it, but they can't change it. Just not right. Raymond Yang's on the bench, resting. He needs it. Kyle White's all over him. Good defensive playing by Kyle White. I'll give it up to him right there. Good strategy by Milton Osborne. You figure you don't want to put one of your scorers, on a box one. It takes away from his scoring, but he's still getting to the hole, and he's still playing D. Don't have a soda, but could I offer you a cookie?
I'll take a piece of a cookie.
A piece or a whole cookie?
I'll take a whole cookie.
Take the whole cookie. It's got sugar in it. It's not sugar-free either. At the line, hits the first.
Yeah.
They need everything they can get, and they're just not getting them rebounds. Carmelo's ice cold. Their rebounding is poor, and they're just not moving the ball well. Complete different team from the first half.
That's nice passing, Brad.
Oh, Amon's got to make him. 0 for 2 on bunnies.
Brad, that was the prettiest transition we've seen all season. And you just got to make the finish.
Right in front of the rim. How do you miss it? And he's tall. It's basically a drop shot. Lichtenberg trying to get it inside again. Amon's got to hit it. Follow it. Hit it. There you go. There's the confidence builder right there. You got that shot. Now stop building on it.
I actually think he's coming down, Brad.
It's possible. This game's so big, some of the Kings have shown up. They're not even playing today. Nice play, Jose. Oh, you left it open for him. Good defense by Amon by standing there. You don't need to jump with him, just put your arms up. Nice trap, good trap. The offensive foul, I pushed a forearm into him.
Told you, Alex came down, Amon came down.
Uh-oh. Good job, Amon, finally got that ball to go and they take him out.
I don't know, he's a big body, Brad, I keep him in there.
Yeah. And he's standing there when they're driving. He's not moving, so he's playing solid D. Lichtenberg, good stop, and he passed it. Oh, you got to shoot that. You did all that work. You had him faked. Hale.
Well, maybe it was right to take him down.
Mata Hale with the three. Down to eight. No foul here, no foul. Andy Perez wants that ball. And they're calling a foul. You gotta stay on your feet.
See, Alex Amon played that the best.
Yeah, he stayed on his feet. You can't jump with him. You just gotta hopefully, you know, put your arms up and hope he misses. Everyone will be in too much foul trouble if they continue this. And he hits free throws, so why put him at the line? That's why he was last year's MVP. How he's not on the high school team, still shocking. Hits them both. Oh, damn.
That was almost a Potsy Weber, Brad.
Yeah.
At the end of third, we got a combo of 80, 45-35.
If my mother's alive, I think she'd be calling me right now. God bless her.
God bless your moms.
Yeah. I missed her. You know her 11-year anniversary just passed?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's weird. What's today? 23rd?
22nd.
22nd. Yeah, 3 days ago.
I'm one of the lucky ones, Brad. I still have mine here.
Well, you're a lucky man. Miss her daily.
And I'm sure that'll be it for the rest of your days.
Yep.
Missing her.
But BG Benton carries her name, so I feel better. I love when people come in and they look so confused. Where do I sit? Yelling out the motion.
That was a nice pass. You gotta make those bunnies.
Now, I know we're supposed to be watching the game, but to my immediate right on the bleachers, maybe a couple up behind me, you see that special hairdo? That was a beautiful pass, and he missed a bunny. Oh, he missed another one. Oh, my goodness. How are you missing? North Face jacket with the yellow in the front?
Yes, I do.
What are you trying to go for with that?
Attention.
Fair enough. As long as you have a goal.
That is quite different.
I thought it was just like a, you know, a hair, you know, a barrette or something.
Mm-hmm.
Nope, it's her hair. At the line. Misses the first. And he just missed two bunnies.
Shooter.
One shot. Violation on the shooter.
Prince Mukala makes it right. Oh, there he goes. You got to cut him off.
Hell yeah.
Oh, nice fake.
Hell yeah.
Oh, they got to get the ball. The rebounding is awful.
They get him for 3 seconds, Brad.
Yeah. That's how the Hawks are beating them, by rebounding. Jonas Saint. Oh!
Clean to me, Brad.
That looked real clean.
This guy's killing
him. He's the best player right now. That guy.
That's only one on him. I thought there was more. Jonas Saint misses the first. Kevin Valley got a birthday.
Happy birthday.
He hits the second. Pistons coming back, still trailing 10. Got it down to 8. That's as close as they've been in a long time. It's the fourth quarter, he can't play around no more. Hans going to the hole, good move. Little out of control. Prince trying to go up, no good. Hans front rims it, not following it.
These Pistons have a hard time capitalizing on the bunnies.
Oh, missing way too many bunnies. And Carmelo's still on the bench. And they're screaming. That's a loose ball, you gotta take that. Take advantage of it, he's gotta hit this. And I knew it. They're missing bunnies left and right. Jose can't finish. Beautiful pass Jimmy by Shu. I told you I love Jimmy Shu.
Jimmy soft Shu.
And Milton screaming. Because he wants Kyle back on Yang. Boxing one. Again with another pass. Beautiful play. And they finally get one. Finally.
They're jumping in the press, Brad. Hap, hap. Oh, maybe it's a one-man man.
Oh, there goes Jonas Saint. See ya. The Hawks are real tough in transition. Back up 12. It's only 6 baskets. They got to find someone to hit the bunnies. Jose for 3. He's been cold. Continues cold. Right through his hands. And no hustle. Travel. Carmelo finally into the game. Just under 6. I don't think these Hawks want to lose. They're like really looking stressed, the coaches. Not even talking about the players. And there's a takedown. Kyle White pushes Yang. They're in the double bonus.
Double bonus.
The clock was running the whole time.
And it's continued to run.
Yep. Well, it doesn't stop till 4. The Pistons got to make this right. They got to do something to turn this momentum around. Hit these two, get a nice steal, you got your momentum. He misses. kind of day the Pistons are having. Hits the second. Sub. Alejandro Berrio coming into the game. Jimmy Shue coming out after that beautiful assist. Berrio coming in. Hands it off to Alley. Bad play. Alley throws it away. Camelo's got to hit one. He got that one. There you go. I said you get your free throw, you get a quick steal. Down to nine. Yang, oh, nice play. You got to stay covering him. Don't let up. Got to play D here. Oh, that's offensive.
Yeah, no, that's a blocking foul.
Yeah, he was on his way down.
Yes, yes. Not only did he not get into the position,
yeah.
He started to fall.
He started to fall. He flopped.
He tried to sell it. Flop. That's the word I'm looking for. He's a flop. He's a flopper.
You're calling him a flopper?
I'm calling him a flopper.
I'm calling his mama and telling him you called him a flopper. Raymond, the flopper Yang. We got a nickname for him.
Possibly comes from a long line of floppers.
It's possible. Three. That's a dagger. Nice rebound by Pepe. That's where the Hawks are killing them, on rebounds. The Pistons cannot get rebounds. That's not a travel. It's a foul. Block on Berrio.
Berrio tried to draw the foul. He tried to draw the charge, but it wasn't happening.
Yep.
Pistons in a double bonus. If they can hit their free throws, Brad.
They got to hit the free throws. Jose's not a very good free throw shooter. Very nice form right there. Good. That looked good right from the release. Nice job. Hits them both. Five seconds. Oh, timeout Hawks. Good timing. That's where they need it. They need their defense. Speaking of defense, Steve Wright entering the building. Day one. You know he was a guest on your show Around the Rim?
Yes.
You were there. The game hasn't started and he's already here. Bullets facing off against the Sonics next game right now. Pistons, Hawks, who will have first place right now? Looks like the Hawks are in good advantage right now, up nine.
When Steve Wright said press record, I don't know if you know, but when he was in the studio Around the Rim last Thursday, Go Ref Go did not press record.
Yes, I was there.
Okay, so it was a straight ingestion into the server.
Unlike don't erase the tape, yeah. But hit record. That's true. We got some old alumni in this gym today. They seem to be showing up every week, too.
And speaking of which, you should have been in the studios. Waldo was dancing with the two sisters who have joined the crew.
Yeah, Waldo will try to be there every week, and I will try to make it down there. Pass up top to Jonas Saint. Raymond Yang.
That's a pair and a half.
Yeah. And he's got all three in this quarter. Starting to play a little D now. Don't have a choice. Fourth quarter and you're trailing. He keeps doing the same move. All you got to do is stand on the left side. You can pick him. Pepe using his arm. Pepe averaging just over seven a game. Yang. Jose for three, way off. No one's following the shots for the Pistons. Mukala.
That was actually it, but he traveled. Oh,
yep.
That was a nice dish off, and he
Prince
walked.
Mukala with the walk. Nice pass by Jose. There, Berrio's got it. You got to trap him. Throws it back to Jonas Saint. Under 3 minutes, the Pistons have to play tight D.
Yo, rotate over.
Nice block. That was clean. They got to take advantage of this. Oh, don't travel. Looking for that three. He's been waiting all game. Still off. No rebound again for the Pistons.
That was ill-advised. Here comes a touchdown. That was ill-advised. And then he comes and commits the foul.
Yeah, well, Alley was gone if he didn't foul him. Stops the clock. Camelo is just ice cold today.
He started out on fire.
Yeah, well, he had a little bit.
Well, as you mentioned, Brad, he doesn't get into much foul trouble, so.
Nope.
Second, he doesn't get any foul trouble off. You played three games of four fouls? Or four games? You played four games of three fouls, then, you know.
Three games of four fouls,
yeah. Then, you know, you're certainly not on the dirty dozen list, I tell you.
Not even close. Alley. Right to that lane.
They got him for steps.
Yep. Type of day the Pistons are having. They want Pepe to inbound it. Throw it away, they gotta get it.
Oh, piston ball.
I thought a piston hit it.
Sebastian just checked in, Brad. He ain't been in there 10 seconds.
Yep, they're doing some sort of defensive transition because Jose's got fouls. They can't afford him to get a foul. So Sebastian will come in for defense and Jose back for offense. McCalla throws it away. Yep, there it goes. Nope, good D, good D. Great D by Jose. Yang's got to control it. That's a foul by White.
One's calling a foul.
Travel.
One's calling a travel.
He calls a foul.
He called a foul.
Oh, he's going to let him have it.
He overruled it.
And look at them. Bonaco strong, and the kid Norman got him. Now you got Jovan going off down the end.
You don't see that often, Brad, when one referee actually overrules the other.
It's about time.
We'd like to see more of it.
Well, the closer ref has the right call. Raymond's got to hit him.
How many times does a closer ref has the right call but doesn't overrule?
How many times has cost a ref?
No matter what ref we have down here, the Hawks just don't find the law.
Everybody has the same ref, so everyone's even. He missed them both. What is going on with the Pistons? Got a foul on Carmelo.
They're
calling on Yang. Wow. He's got four. Pepe at the line. Misses. Pistons got a rebound and go. Under 2 minutes, trailing by 13. He's got to hit it. He's way off. Jose cannot finish. If they can't do anything, without hitting free throws, they're not getting rebounds. It looks like the Hawks will come down with a combo of 20 straight wins. And the Pistons dropped a second.
Combo 100.
It is. I was just about to say that, but you interrupted me. It's very rude. You should be a little more respectful and alert me when it's going to be a combo so I can get one. Now, a lot of points, 100 even, 145 to go, down 12, make it 11. He's hit his last four in a row, so you want to keep him on the line. And he's wide open. Who's covering him?
Somebody blew the assignment.
Big time. And a foul by Carmelo. That's only three on him. But he has to foul, so there's no choice there. Yang back in with four fouls. Doesn't matter. Minute 40 left. It's not out of reach, but you got to hope he misses. And Allie, don't miss too much at that line. He missed. You gotta go, you gotta go. You can't hold it. He's nice pass. Hans gets the basket. Now you gotta play D, but don't leave that man open again. Oh, I wouldn't have fouled him. You trapped him. That was the perfect opportunity for a steal. You got it down to 9. Oh, bad foul.
They fouled the wrong guy.
Yeah.
And he's going to shoot 2 of them.
Well, you know they're trying to get him the ball no matter what. So you got to double team him and hope the other guy can't catch it.
It's called deny defense.
Allie for the first shot. No good. Allie's starting to struggle now. He's getting tired himself.
I don't think he's been off the floor all game, Brad, has he?
I don't believe he has. He hits the second. Back to 10. That's 5 possessions, unless the Pistons can hit some threes, and I just don't see it. Oh, he throws it away. Carmelo. Doesn't matter now. It's all a wrap. Not enough time for the Pistons to come back. They can't hit their threes. They can't follow the rebounds. That's a deep deuce.
He didn't call glass, Brad.
Nope, and they got the man who should have it. Oh, they're letting him go. It doesn't matter. You can't celebrate. Still losing. You need the steal. Oh, what a pass. What a rebound. The Pistons are just not crashing that rim. Allie back at the line, 1 for his last 4. One for 5. Quick sub. 49.1 to go. 59-49. Hawks. Oh, misses again. Got a push. He's got to hit it. He can't finish. Missed about 7 of them today. Pepe with the ball, passing it in.
Go, go, go.
Gotta go. Might want some threes.
There's your wish.
There's one. You gotta cover him. And they keep giving it to Allie. Oh, he was Kyle. Thank God Kyle White was wide open.
They pull it within 7.
But Allie's back at the line. He's been missing. Raymond Yang, I believe, has 5 or 6 threes today. John Carmelo, disappearing act today. Got that one, 2 for 7. He struggled at the end, but they had a big enough lead where they could afford to do that. And he misses that one. Pistons got to come out long way. 20 seconds. Trying to set the pick. There's the 3. No good. A rebound by Pepe. You might as well let him go. It's over. 8 points down, 13 seconds. No way the Pistons can come back.
Come on, Dave, get it right.
Joey Pepe at the line. .6, 60-52. Pepe at the line shooting 2. Hits the first. Joey Pepe had himself a pretty good game today. The Hawks found a replacement for from one of the guys who moved on from last year. Pepe doing a good job. Camelo coming up. The Hawks don't even have to play D. Oh, blocked by Pepe, as I mentioned it. Oh, and Kyle White got tripped. And Allie rips off his jersey for what reason, I don't know. Maybe it was a little hot. Allie Joseph, the Mia Hamm of the MNBL, ripping off his shirt. Right now, your Hawks, double digits, 20-0 straight. Winning in the fourth quarter, transition offense always pays off big for the Hawks. And how can you say a team that really doesn't have a lot of height just out-rebounded a Piston team that did not follow any shots?
What they lack in height, they make up for in hot, obviously.
Absolutely. The Hawks continued dominance in the MNBL. The Pistons had everything going their way. They had momentum going into the halftime. They were up one. Next thing you know, the Hawks turn it on after the halftime conversation, we'll say. We're not allowed to put microphones in their locker room anymore. So they come out 4-0. Pistons drop to 3-1. Wrap it up. That was a game.
Pistons, they made a game out of it. The Pistons, they got a good season ahead of them. So hopefully they won't let this distract them. Somebody has to go home with the L. They're starting off 3-1. I don't think they won three games all last year. So, you know, good things for the Pistons this 2011 season.
That's true.
For Bradworth Benton. Storm and Norm behind the camera. I'm Nestor Dudley saying we'll be seeing youth at the games.
Love you, baby girl.
For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com. Telview Corporation is a broadcast technology company that specializes in workflow solutions for public, education, and government television stations, digital signage, and cable and satellite TV applications. For more information, please go to www.telview.com.